Last track analysis video. You know how I said that there was a lack of interest to this round? Well, they have this as the World Championship. No, it's not. The FIM has the World Supercross Series, so it's funny. It means that they're nervous with the whole FIM Supercross deal. Same thing with motocross. They're nervous that this new series is going to come in and take over. I have a love-hate relationship with this track. I hate the venue. It should be at Vegas. I love the technicality of the track. I hate the sand. But I do love how different it is. Come around a 180 degree corner, you have a double, then possibly a triple, then a quad. At least the first go around, then it's gonna be different with, you know, probably a triple, triple, then step over, step over. Then you got a double here. This section is silly because guys are just gonna go to the inside and they're gonna drift wide. And so it's going to be fairly one line. This whole section of the track is going to be one line besides it being a long whoop section, which is cool. But guys are going to go to the inside, cover themselves here. The next section, they're going to go to the inside, maybe roll, double, triple. If they could, maybe triple after the roll. But going outside, you set yourself up for getting block passed. And then nice fancy triple. The next rhythm section has got some different lines in it too, and it's a 180 degree corner, which is helpful because it's going to help with some of the passing. So guys are going to triple, then they're going to triple again, and then double into the sand, which the sand is going to stop you. I hate sand on supercross track because your suspension is so stiff it doesn't move with the bike. You got to have like very loamy soft suspension to deal with sand, and not to mention the roost, the goggles, it gets everywhere. It's a real shitty thing altogether. Then that section right there before this little triple here, guys probably aren't going to be able to seat bounce triple that, especially if they got pressure from another rider. They're going to have to try to hold the inside line there. Guys might be able to block pass there, which that's a cool little passing point. It's cool that we're going zigzagging across the start a few times, which I do like that fact. Guys are going to be prepared for motocross, so they don't want to just kill themselves for nothing, right? Unless you're sort of in the championship deal, but nobody's really in the championship deal. Craig's really the only one that has to really push hard. On the 250s, you've got Jet and Hunter that potentially couldn't get in Craig's way. Do I think Anderson is probably going to be the guy to beat in the 450 class? Yes. Mookie, this is his last chance to try to win a race, not just get on the podium. So look for him to come out swinging. Barsha, same thing. He wants to be on the top step of the podium. So I think those three guys, it might be fairly interesting. The dirt in Utah, like, it's just lackluster. I know Vegas doesn't have very good dirt either, but it's Vegas. Everything in Vegas is always a bigger hype because afterwards you can go party, go do all stuff. Everyone's happy. You know, it's like an exciting thing. This whole thing with just changing the name to World Supercross or World Championship doesn't do it for me. Let me know in the comments below if you agree, disagree. I'll read all the comments. I try to, at least. Until next time, let's look forward to Moto. I do have some videos coming out with Cooksey and Rob. We should be getting together to do our analysis because I apparently am effing wrong more often than I am right. Let's fix that.